Welcome back to Twitter Business, everybody. All eyes are on President Trump as he lands in Japan for the much-anticipated G20 summit. On his agenda, meetings with Chinese President Xi Jinping amid ongoing trade tensions and his first sit-down with the Russian President Vladimir Putin since the release of the Mueller report. Edward Stringham is the president of the American Institute for Economic Research and joins us now. Ed, great to have you here.
Thanks so much, Hope.
So we know what these high-profile meetings are going to be, at least who he's meeting with, but what are you looking for out of these meetings?
So a lot is at stake. Mnuchin has said there's a 90% chance that they can negotiate a trade deal. But just recently he said there was a 95% chance. So he's kind of backtracking. A lot of my colleagues at the American Institute for Economic Research and I, we always debate, is the president bluffing? Is he intentionally maybe trying to cause problems to say, hey, look at all this. Is it a negotiating tactic? Or does he really want tariffs? And I think if he really wants tariffs, that is tremendously disruptive towards the economy. And if he's going to be pushing that line, I think it's going to be tremendously bad for American corporations.
Take us through why this is a bad move for the U.S. economy.
They often pitch tariffs as, oh, we're going to help out Americans. Actually, taxes on American consumers.
President Trump does not believe that, by the way.
Sometimes he says, I am not a tariff man. He believes
he doesn't believe that it's a tax on American consumers.
Right, right.
He seems to think that tariffs are paid for by the countries that tariffs are
imposed on. Exactly. But at the end of the day, it's American consumers and American corporations who are paying that. So when an American corporation buys ingredients from other countries, such as steel, such as aluminum, they're going to be the ones who are going to be having to pay for that. That's disrupting supply chains for a lot of American manufacturers who design goods here and have them assembled overseas, or they design goods here and have them assembled here with foreign components. And that goes all the way down the line, especially with consumer electronics, where there's a lot of components coming from around the world.
All right, that as the backdrop here, the big, of course, conclusion that we're looking for is a deal. How likely is it, in your opinion, in your research, that this is going to be the outcome?
I mean, I'm hoping Mnuchin is being serious when he says 90% chance. I think would be great. If it actually happens, it would be very good for the economy. Right now, there's a lot of uncertainty, and I think that's been tempering otherwise very strong stock markets.
What do you make of the Chinese sort of response, or at least preemptively talking about what they're looking for out of this deal coming overnight?
Well, I think that the American government has been, in my opinion, mistreating certain companies such as Huawei. I guess it's pronounced Huawei, but they're targeting individual companies, saying you can't sell components to American consumers, American corporations, and now arresting people. I would be very concerned if I was working for that company or if I was a representative of that government, where the American trade negotiations are individually targeting certain corporations. I find very troubling.
Why do you think the Republican Party has seemingly embraced a president that calls himself tariff man? This is the party of free trade. This
sure,
is the party
yeah.
That refers to Adam Smith.
That's exactly. Historically, there was the U.S. Chamber of Commerce wing of the Republican Party. Typically, we don't want government interfering too much. Now this is actually having government interfere with a huge amount of supply chains all throughout the entire global economy. I think it's a kind of a switch towards populism in a certain way, which is actually going against the historical, I would say, pro-business interests.
Where does that leave the Democrats? And, this comes against the backdrop of us being in the midst of the first Democratic debate. And there was some talk of business last night and wealth being controlled by a top portion of the social class here in the United States. But where does this leave Democrats if the Republican Party is embracing tariffs?
I think it's funny because 20, not in a good way, but 20 years ago, both parties were strongly pro-free trade. Pretty much all economists, including myself, are pro-free trade. And now we've got the Republican Party abandoning that, the Democrat Party not even really talking about that. I guess in some ideal, I'd like to hope for them saying, look, we're going to be just traditional, middle-of-the-road, pro-free trade people. But I just don't see that on any, out of any really political candidate at all.
One part of the conversation that is now, I think, more in focus is our relationship with Iran. It came up last night in the debates, and I wonder how much of that will be talked about during the G20. What do you think? Is it important for these leaders to discuss right now?
Oh, I mean, there's just so many geopolitical issues right now, and those can really interfere with corporations outside the United States, also corporations in the United States. So anything that can disrupt normal commerce is bad for market prices.
Give us your take on the Fed for the remainder of the year. Are you thinking there's going to be several rate cuts priced in, or several rate cuts happening, excuse me? Are they priced in? Does there need to be a rate cut?
So half a year ago, they were saying we're going to continue moving up to historically normal interest rate levels. They've been reversing course on that for the past few weeks, especially last Friday. Powell had his latest thing. Yeah, we're probably going to cut rates. So if you look at the forward guidance from Federal Reserve officials, which is saying what we think, as in they think we're going to do, most of them are indicating possible rate cuts. If you look at the futures markets, which can implied probabilities of rate cuts are in there. So I think that's actually going to happen. I think they're actually papering over some of these problems from global trade tensions and global trade wars. So it's muting, I think, some serious underlying issues in the economy.
All right. Ed Stringham, president of the American Institute for Economic Research. Thanks so much for joining us on this. We appreciate
it. Thanks, Tim. Thanks, Hope.
Coming up, you guys.